Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at how you take a screenshot on your iPhone or iPad and then email that to someone. So as an app developer, I sometimes get questions from my users. Like for instance, in my most recent game, Word Tiles, I might get a question about how the scoring works. And they try to give an example, but it's not complete. So I say, well, just send me a screenshot and I'll explain it to you. And this happens a lot to app developers who just want to see a screenshot of what the user is seeing when they're asking a question. And I'm surprised how many people don't know how to take a screenshot, because it's pretty easy in iOS on the iPhone or iPad to take a screenshot. Basically, you do it in two steps. The first step is to take the screenshot. The second step is to do something with it, like say email it to somebody. So let me show you how to do both. What you want to first do is take the shot, which involves using the two physical buttons on the device. And that's the sleep-wake button, which is usually at the top of your iPad or iPhone, and the home button, which is on the front at the bottom. If you press these at the same time, then it will take a screenshot and place it in your photo library. Now if you have an iPhone 6 Plus, they've moved the sleep-wake button to the side, and I expect them to be doing that on some of the future devices as well. But either way, you find that sleep-wake button and the home button, press them at the same time, and you'll hear a sound and sometimes see the screen flash as it just did. And that puts it in the photo library. So let's go take a look at the photo library now. And there's my Photos app. And in there, I want to go and click or tap on Albums at the bottom. And you can see I've got Camera Roll. And that's for photos that I've taken with my device or screenshots. Also things that apps create. So an app that creates an image will put it in the Camera Roll. And if I tap on it there, I see I have that one image there. Now I can email to somebody many different ways. For instance, I can tap on it to go to the screenshot. I'm still in the Photos app looking at the screenshot, not at the actual app again. And I can use a share button at the bottom left. And I could share it by text message or mail or however I want to do it. I could also just start a new message in Mail, hit the Compose button, and I could just tap twice in the body of the message and I'll get Insert Photo or Video as one of the choices there. And then I can choose from the Camera Roll, choose that image, hit the Use button, and now it's inserted into my email message. And I can still write text before or after it. And that's how you take a screenshot on an iPad or iPhone and email to somebody.